And good morning to you. Today is Wednesday. It is December the 15th. And I am your host, the Troublemaker Extraordinaire, coming to you recorded from the comforts of my lazy boy recliner here at Wake Up Central with the Wednesday edition of the Morning Wake Up Call. Yes, indeed. It is most definitely Wednesday. That means we are halfway through the week. It's hump day midweek. And I tell you what, it's not going to be too much longer till we'll be back into the weekend. And I hope you're already making some plans to have a wonderful weekend. I have an awesome show lined up for you today. But before we get started, I have one thing and one thing only on my mind. And that is, I am happier than a tick on a fat dog. And boy, that's happiness right there, my friend. All right, let's see. What do we got to do first? Let's say hi to my trusty co-host, Grandpa.
Yes. How are you doing today?
Oh, I'm doing fine, Grandpa. How about yourself?
Oh, I can't complain.
Did you sleep well last night?
Oh, yes. I slept well. That's great.
You ready to do the show?
Sure, let's do a show.
Okay, here we go. We're going to do the weather, okay?
Sure.
Okay, here we go. According to the National Weather Service, we are looking at a chance of freezing rain and sleet before noon, and then freezing rain likely after that. Cloudy with a high near 36. Tonight, rain or freezing rain is likely, becoming all rain after midnight. Otherwise, cloudy, the low will be 34. All right, and for the guys across the pond, over at Bobby's Bar Waterloo, Grandpa, you gonna do the weather forecast for our buddies in the UK?
Oh, yeah, sure. Let's see, we're looking at white clouds with the rain and the temperature of 6.
All right, good job, Grandpa. And guess what?
What's that?
We've got to say hi to Lee over at Bobby's Bar.
Hi, Lee.
Yeah, today is Lee's birthday.
Oh, well, happy birthday there, Lee.
All right, so to Lee, we want to say happy birthday to you from Grandpa and I and the staff here at Wake Up Call. All right, today's show, how to behave at the office Christmas party. You going to a Christmas party this year, Grandpa?
Nah, I don't think so.
All right, well, anyway, I tell you what, just in case you do, I guess you're retired now, aren't you?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, well, anyway, I guess this could go for, like, any party, but this is, you know, office party here. So we're going to learn how to behave at the office Christmas party. Making a fool of yourself at the office Christmas party is something that should be avoided at all costs. After all, you will be obliged to front up those very same coworkers the following week. And if they have a remarkably low opinion of you since the party, it'll feel a little bit more awkward. While the Christmas party can create worries for both employer and employee, it is an event where you can still behave professionally and have fun, and provides a great opportunity to socialize with coworkers and bosses within the company whom you normally would not have a chance to mingle with. It all comes down to a simple mantra: behave right and you'll have a great night. That kind of rhymes, doesn't it?
Yeah, that's funny.
All right. And here are some straightforward suggestions to keep this part of your work social event calendar, a good thing. Here we go. Number one, prepare yourself mentally to show up. Rather than dreading the occasion, the right mindset can provide a much needed balance. Regardless of how you feel about the office or the party, office parties are a crucial part of the office dynamic. Think of it like a Sunday afternoon visit to grandma's. Even if you don't feel like it, you know that you should probably go.
Grandma?
I'm just reading the script, man.
That's wrong.
I know. Everybody loves grandma, don't you?
Yeah, right.
What, you don't love grandma?
Oh, yeah. I love grandma.
Okay, here we go. All right, next step. Next step, we got to decide what we're going to wear. Find out from everybody else what they are wearing before the party and match the tone with your outfit. If it's a casual dress, and you turn up smart, then that will immediately put you on the back foot and make you a little uneasy or uncomfortable for the rest of the evening. And it also opens you up for an easy target for poking fun at. The same applies the other way around. If you are a woman, find a compromise between I'm attractive and sexy and take me seriously, I'm a professional. Revealing clothing, while fun, is not appropriate around your superiors. Think beyond the event to the image you'll like your co-workers to retain of you in the months to come. If everyone is heading straight to the party from work, then you don't have that much to worry about. What do you think about that, Gramps?
Oh, that's good, that's good. But I like the sexy chicks, though.
Yeah, me too. Alright, are you wanting to arrive on time? Turning up fashionably late is not an option and could have you missing out on some of the fun. Arrive on time. This gives you the opportunity to say hello to everyone and still gives you an early out without seeming rude. You also want to mingle. Be sure to acknowledge all of your co-workers, especially your superiors and their associates as well, but and this will put you in good stead. The Christmas party is an excellent opportunity to cement relationships and get to be known in a good way.
Yeah, that's cool. I like that.
Yeah, me too. You know, you gotta mingle, right? You gotta mix and mingle.
Yeah. You don't want to be rude or anything, you know. Someone might think you're a jerk.
Yeah, you definitely wouldn't want that to happen. Alright, next step. You want to be tactful and careful about declaring your underlying romantic intentions.
What?
Yeah, it happens, Gramps. This is, you know, the 21st century, man. It's that time of the year, you know. If you're having an office blowout and Gina from HR is there, you may be tempted to make your move. This could go either way. Remember, you will have to see this person at work on Monday. Think. Do I really fancy them, or do they like me? How much have I had to drink? Will I regret this in the morning? This is called a reality check. If you fail the reality check, under no circumstances should you make your move. If, however, you have strong feelings for this person, and this person may be an opportunity you have been waiting for, so take a stab at it.
Yeah, I heard Gina in HR is kind of cute.
You gonna ask Gina out?
Nah.
Okay. Help others. If you see a coworker overdoing the drinking or making a move that is clearly not cognizant, step in and bail them out. Explain to them what they are doing and how it appears to the other people. And if it doesn't sink in, then discreetly ring a cab and take them home. This is one time where your own executive decision-making can save their reputation. You could always return to the party after you get finished taking the other person home. But, you know, when you get back, don't bring up what you've done, you know. You know, it's just, you know, just drop it. You know what I'm saying?
Why would I want to do that?
You gotta help out your coworkers, man.
Well, what if they're like, you know, a jerk or something? Should I still help them out?
You know, I would.
Oh.
All right, quote of the day. Let's see here. Many a man who falls in love with a dimple makes the mistake of marrying the whole girl. That comes from Ibn Azar. That's kind of cute. And let's see here. Useless information. Peanuts are an ingredient of dynamite.
What?
Yeah. Have you ever seen peanuts and dynamite?
Is that the reason why they like explode in my stomach when I eat them?
Probably so. You get the little backfire?
Yeah.
All right. Well, anyway, there you go, boys and girls. That is today's show. I hope you have enjoyed the show just as much as Grandpa and I have had getting the show on the air. And, you know, we hope that you have a wonderful day, don't you, Grandpa?
Yeah. Have a great day.
All right, but before we get out of here, we got to do the legal mumbo jumbo.
You're the legal who what?
Legal mumbo jumbo. You know, the lawyers make me do it.
You have lawyers?
Yeah, I got lawyers. You know. All right, legal mumbo jumbo. Ready for this, Gramps?
Yeah, sure, let's go.
All right, the views and opinions expressed in this show are those of the host, guests, and fans, and not necessarily those of any organization represented by these individuals. Wake Up Call is a production of Free Speech Communications, or may be replayed at any time for your viewing pleasure. The content of this show is meant to only be entertaining and possibly sarcastic. Should you have any issues regarding the show, you are encouraged to forward any and all comments to my Facebook account. What are you doing, Gramps?
Oh, I got lost.
Yeah, I see.
You talk fast.
Yeah, I should be an auctioneer, huh?
Oh.
Never mind. All right, Gramps, say bye.
Yeah, bye. I hope you had a good show. Yeah. We'll see you tomorrow.
All right, yes, as Grandpa says, we will see you tomorrow. We'll be back here with the Thursday edition of Wake Up Call. We're going to do a special tomorrow for our guys across the pond. So, hope you tune in tomorrow, and Grandpa and I are like the inverted belly button.
Yeah, we're out of here.